Hey, are you new to design or maybe not even a designer at all, but you find yourself responsible for making a digital product or experience? Maybe you've heard of wireframes, but really aren't even sure what they are. Well, let me walk you through some examples right here on YouTube to help explain them. But first, let's define what wireframes are. At Balsamiq, we say wireframes are a simple sketch of a user interface, and they can be used for a variety of reasons. We're going to use the same principle for why wireframes are so effective by showing you what I mean instead of simply talking about them. When I say go, click on the full screen icon located over there and we'll change the screen to wireframe mode. Then I'll show you what wireframes are and why we use them. Okay, I'm going to give you a few seconds to find that button. Okay, ready? Go! Whoa, look at this. A much simpler form of a website, right? It doesn't look like a real website, just, you know, the structure of one. Just black and white colors, lines and shapes, you know, some boxes and scribbles. We do have some text in here, but maybe it's not final yet. It's just a simplified version of a real website. All right, let's switch back to the full Fidelity site and you can see the difference. See? It's pretty much the same, only pared down. Okay, what about this? It's a simple marker sketch, but you can still see the structure of the page and how it's intended to work, right? All right, let's take a look at various sketches of this page in wireframe form. Nice, okay. Okay, I like this one. Let's turn this one into a mid-fidelity wireframe. This is something you can show a user, client, or a stakeholder and get great feedback on your idea. Usually we create a few screens of this to show people how they can move through it. That's what we call a user or wire flow. You know what, let me just show you really quick. Okay, so a user is gonna land on this page, or either one, search for a new video, two, leave a comment, or three, click on a new video to watch. See, I just walked you through what that would be like. Okay, check this version out. Look at all that detail. It looks almost like a real website, right? Well, this is an example of a high fidelity wireframe. We combine these with annotations when we are sending a site off to be coded by a development team that typically doesn't work too closely with the designer product team. If there's limited communication between the people building the site and the designers, they need lots of details in order to ensure that they're making the site the way it was intended. All right, let's switch back to mid-fidelity. See, mid-fidelity wireframes are great for showing people your idea. They're super quick to make and they make your idea real-ish, enough to get that feedback that's critical at this stage. Okay, why don't we take a look at the landing page design as a wireframe? Let's try a few new designs of this page. Okay, what if we highlight a certain video more prominently? There we go. Okay, what about having a big video area playing the video when you land right on the page? It's probably gonna need a mute button, but you can just probably put it right there. I don't know, maybe this is too distracting. It's pretty big. You can't really see any other content, but the whole point of this exercise of wireframe is to explore as many options as you can come up with. But also try not to do this alone. Invite other people to generate ideas with you. All right, so to sum it up, sketching in low fidelity wireframes are a great place to start when you're creating something completely new. Simple is fine, it's more about the idea than the drawing. Do as many as you can. Mid fidelity is great for when you have an idea and you want to show users or clients. Use mid fidelity wireframes to create click-throughs or prototypes so everyone can understand how the user will flow through the software or app. High fidelity wireframes are pretty extreme and should be used only when you're throwing over the fence for development. Okay, well that's it for me. I hope this was fun. Let me know if you want to see any more videos like this and I'll make them.